Once you logged into your Moodle course, you will see a button called Start the Meeting for you to join a Zoom or Teams meeting. This is a brand new feature for both teachers and students. The meeting link is automatically generated, so there's no need for a teacher to set up a meeting manually, and you can log on to your online class in a convenient fashion with a click of a button. When you're in the Zoom meeting, it's important to make sure these features, make sure that you're not on mute. You click the button to unmute yourself. You can select different sources of audio, so your microphone. It is recommended to pick the USB audio here, which is connected to the classroom microphone. You can test this by speaking into it. You'll see that there's going to be a color in the icon here. This shows that it's working. And secondly, the video. If you click on this sign, you will see that the camera is up. This is the integrated webcam. You can choose different cameras. If you click on the classroom name here, for example, then it will show the back view of the entire classroom, which might be useful in some cases. Another source of camera would be this UVC camera. This is connected to the digitizer here, and you will be able to conduct a part of your lecture there. So teachers can use different cameras to fit their lecture. In order to conduct your lecture, you can click Share Screen, select your PowerPoint slide or any applications you want to be teaching with, and make sure you click Share Computer Sound at the bottom here so that your audio, your voice is recorded as well. So you click Share, and now you can conduct your lecture. So when recording the Zoom lecture, teachers have two options in doing so. Firstly, is to record to the computer locally, and secondly, is to record to the cloud. Teachers can do this by clicking this button on the right called Record. If you click on it, you will see the two options. Record on this computer means that the recorded lecture will be saved as a file locally to the computer. Teachers can upload this file either on Panopto or Moodle afterwards. The second option is to record to the cloud. After the Zoom lecture, teachers will receive an email notification with a link. Teachers can use this link to share their Zoom lecture with students. After recording the Zoom lecture to the computer locally, you will be able to find a downloaded lecture file under Documents, and you click Zoom, and you will see the lecture date. You'll go into this to find the recorded video here. So in order to upload this on Moodle, you will enter the Moodle course. You will select Turn Editing On. Then you will add an activity, click File, and then Add. So here you can name your video, select the file under Zoom, the file that we have just recorded, open it, upload this file. You can save and display the file by clicking the button, and here it is. So that was our recorded video. So some teachers might want to record their lectures on Panopto. In this scenario, so we have everything set up on Zoom, you're ready to give the lecture. You will open up Panopto, assuming you've already logged in to your account. Here, you will have to make sure you select the right folder. This will be your Moodle course folders. So we select the right folder. The next thing you need to make sure is the video. Make sure that it's on none. The audio must be on USB, which is the microphone here. And then make sure to click Capture Computer Audio. And then these two boxes, Capture PowerPoint and Capture Main Screen, must be ticked as well. So you will click Record. This will start recording on Panopto, and then you can give your lecture normally. After you have conducted your lecture, you can stop the recording by going back to Panopto and clicking Stop. This will automatically save your recordings to Moodle, so you will not have to upload or do anything. After the video's been processed, you will be able to see it on Moodle. If you enter the Moodle course, you'll be able to see it under Panopto here. That was the video that we have just uploaded. So while some students are going to be joining online through Zoom, some other students could be joining in real life. So for those students, teachers might want to interact more with them by being in this space rather than being in front of the webcam all the time. So as an option, you could bring in another computer, set it up at the front, and conduct your lectures with a bit more freedom in terms of the movement. In order to do this, you will have to log in to the Zoom meeting on two devices.